Now let us move on to the last exercise of the chapter, exercise 6.4. First problem, Pooja wants to buy a mixer which costs rupees 2300 and a cooker that costs rupees 1750. If she has rupees 3500, how much more money does she need to buy them? Okay, now a girl named Pooja wants to buy a mixer and a cooker of rupees 2300 and 1750 respectively, but she has only 3500 rupees. So you have to find out how much more amount she wants to buy them. Okay, so let us solve the problem in the book. Okay, so Pooja wants to buy a mixer and a cooker. So first sentence will be, cost of mixer, so that is rupees 2300. Then cost of cooker, that is rupees 1750. Therefore total cost, you have to add and find out the answer. Okay, so when you add here, only here itself you must add. Okay, 0, 5, 7 plus 3 is 7, 8, 9, 10. So 1 here, 2, 3, 4. So rupees 4050, right? Now, how much amount she has? Only rupees 3500. So amount with Pooja, that is rupees 3500, right? 3500. So therefore more money required. So what you have to do here, you have to subtract and find out. So 4050 minus 3500. Okay, so let us subtract. 0 minus 0 is 0, 5 minus 0 is 5, 0 minus 5 is not possible, so make it 3 here. 10 minus 5 is 5, 3 minus 3 is 0. So the answer is rupees 550. Rupees 550 is required to buy them both. Let us move on to the next problem. The cost of 9 bags of wheat is rupees 4050. What is the cost of 21 bags of wheat? So the cost of 9 bags is 4050 rupees. So you have to find out the cost of 21 bags. So you write cost of 9 bags. What is the cost of 9 bags? It is rupees 4050. Then you write cost of 21 bags. So you write therefore cost of 21 bags. So you have to find out how to find out. Let me solve the rough work here. So one side you have bags, one side you have rupees. So what you have to do, you write here bags dash rupees. Okay, I'll write RS as the short form. So 9 bags, it is 4050. So for 9 bags it is rupees 4050. So for 21 bags you have to find out. So how much? So the question mark, you don't know the answer. Then here we have to cross multiply. So just cross multiply like this, put the multiplication sign. Okay, this problem you are studying for the first time, so listen carefully. So here you have cross multiplied. So here you see, here there's into mark is multiplied with 9, so don't consider that. Here there are two numbers, here there is only one number, here there is question mark. So consider these two, that is 4050 into 21. Okay, so you have to multiply here, you have to multiply. So you know the multiplication, do it. So 2 zeros are 0, sorry, 1 0 is a 0, 1 5 is a 5, 1 0 is a 0, 1 4 is a 4. Then you leave one place here. 2 0 is a 0, 2 5 is a 10, 2 0 is a 0 plus 1, 2 4 is a 8. Then you add 0, 5, 0, 4 plus 1 is 5 and 8. So 85,050 is the answer, right? 85,050 is the answer. So this answer you have to divide by 9. So 85,050 divide by 9. This 9 here, 9 is remaining, so that you will get the answer here. Okay, this multiplication we have to, this division we have to do now. So I'll do it here. You see here 85,050 divided by 9. Right. So 9 how much is 85? You write 9 ones a table here. 9, 18, 27, then 36, 45, 54, 63, 72, 81 and 90, right? It is a 9 ones a table. You see here where 85 comes. 85 comes between 81 and 90. So you will consider the smaller number. So that is 9 nines a 81. Then subtract here. When you subtract, you will get 5 minus 1 is 4, here 0. Bring the next number down. So that is 40. 9 how much is 40? It comes here. So 9 4 is 36. Subtract, you will get 4. Bring 5 down. 9 how much is 45? 9 5 is 45. Right? When you subtract, you will get 0. But still here 1 0 is remaining. If you bring the 0 down, there is no value for 0. So you have to take that 0 here. So the answer is 9,450, right? 9,450, right? You have to write it here. Rupees 9,450 is the answer. This is the third problem. 520 books are arranged in 4 shelves. How many books are arranged in 32 such shelves? So there are 520 books in 4 shelves. So you have to find out how many books are there in 32 shelves. Similar to the previous problem, you have to make 2 columns, like one side books and one side shelves. Yes. So 520 books are arranged in 4 shelves. You write books in 4 shelves. How many? 520. Therefore, books in 32 shelves. Okay. So again, you make 2 columns. One side shelves, one side books. So 4 shelves, there are 520 books, right? 4 shelves, there are 520 books. So in 32 shelves, how many books? Then cross multiply. First, what you have to do, see here there is only one number. So you have to write this number first. So 520 into 32 and multiply. 2 zeros are 0, 2 twos are 4, 2 fives are 10. Then 3. 3 zeros are 0, 3 twos are 6, 3 fives are 15. So 0, 4, 6, 6, 1. So 16,640. Now you have to divide 16,640 by 4. So it is 16,640 by 4. So 1 you cannot, so consider 2 numbers. 4, 4 is 16. So 0, bring 6 down. 4, 1 is 4. So 2, bring 4 down. Right, so 4, how much is 24? 4, 6 are 24, 0. Here there is 1 0 is remaining. I told you, if there is 0 is remaining, then you have to move it here. So the answer is 4160. So here you write the answer, it is 4160. See the last problem. A book cost rupees 15 and pencil cost rupees 4. Mohan buys 2 books and 3 pencils. How much money he should pay altogether? So first you write cost of book. Cost of one book. So it is rupees 15. So he will buy how many books? He will buy 2 books. Then second sentence, cost of one pencil. One pencil, it is rupees 4. So Mohan buys 2 books and 3 pencils. So therefore, cost of 2 books. So if one book is 15, 2 books will be 15 into 2. So what's the cost? 5 2 is 10, 5 1 is 2 5 is 10, 2 1 is 2 plus 3. So it is answer is 30. Then he will buy 3 pencils. Cost of 3 pencils. So 1 pencil is 4 rupees. So 3 pencil will be 4 3 is 12. So rupees 12. Therefore, total cost. So you have to add these two. So 30 plus 12. 0 plus 2 is 2, 3 plus 1 is 4. So the answer is rupees 42.